Peacekeeping operations are specific to the UN. However, despite having been beefed up in recent years with more detailed and more extended mandates, mandates that are backed with wider authorization to use force in order to uphold the mandate, peacekeeping missions are sometimes not forceful enough to impose on a reluctant government the will of the international community. More fighting power is needed, and more military force needs to be engaged. After Iraq invaded Kuwait in August 1990, the Security Council acted together, determined the existence of a breach of international peace and security, and required that Iraq immediately withdrew its troops from Kuwait, Resolution 660. Acting under Chapter 7, the Security Council imposed an extended embargo against Iraq in order to put pressure on it and to try to secure compliance with its previous resolution, and the embargo resolution is Resolution 661. Iraq did not withdraw its troops from Kuwait. On 29 November 1990, the Security Council adopted Resolution 678. It gave Iraq, I quote, "one final opportunity as a pose of goodwill to comply fully with the previous resolutions demanding that Kuwait's sovereignty be restored." Acting under Chapter 7, the Council authorized member states cooperating with the government of Kuwait unless Iraq on or before 15 January 1991 fully implements the previous resolutions to use all necessary means to uphold and implement Resolution 660 and all subsequent relevant resolutions and to restore international peace and security in the area, Resolution 678. Iraq did not take that last chance, and Operation Desert Storm began on 17 January 1991. Kuwait was liberated, and the combat operations ended on 28 February 1991. The authorization to use all necessary means is a diplomatic euphemism to give a green light to wage war. The authorization to use force formula is not to be found as such in the Charter, but it is usually justified under Article 42, which reads as follows. Should the Security Council consider that its non-forcible measures would be inadequate or have proved to be inadequate, it may take such action by air, sea or land forces as may be necessary to maintain or restore international peace and security. Such actions may include demonstrations, blockade and other operations by air, sea or land forces of members of the United Nations. End of quote. The authorized military operations are not conducted by the United Nations, but by the member states that decide to engage their armed forces in the authorized military operation. States are never compelled to commit troops. They are authorized to do so. And most of the time, the state contributing the largest contingent will take the commanding lead of what are often referred to as multinational forces. The states taking part in the operations are requested to keep the Security Council regularly informed of the actions undertaken pursuant to the authorization. And the Security Council may, of course, rescind its authorization as it sees fit at any time. Because the use of force is authorized by the Security Council, it must be understood that such use would be illegal absent the authorization. And this may be debatable as far as the situation of Kuwait in 1990 was concerned, and indeed, at the very beginning of the crisis, when it imposed an embargo on Iraq, the Council referred to the right of individual and collective self-defense in the preamble of Resolution 661. Be that as it may, it is certain that an authorization is not a recommendation. The authorization to use all necessary means formula has been repeated on a few occasions over the years. Multinational forces have been authorized to use force in Somalia, Haiti, Rwanda, Eastern Zaire, Albania, Bosnia and Herzegovina, East Timor, Bunia in the DRC, Liberia, and Libya. Each time, states are authorized to use force in order to secure and achieve a certain outcome. In other words, the definition of the mandate given to the multinational forces is of crucial importance, and the absence of a clear purpose for the use of force will result in the Council being divided about the authorization. And let us turn now to that mandate issue.